Band of music, mm-hmm. I guess they call it, called Christian Country.
In fact, last year, he won a couple of different top male vocalist awards. His album is called Heavenly High. In fact, the title cut just went to number one. Tonight, he's doing a song called Wrong Place at the Right Time, and this is Bruce Haynes.
Charlie had a business meeting scheduled out of town, and when he read the address, the cart was upside down. He pulled into the parking lot, straightened up his tie. He sure looked nice, and he expected sales and figures, but Lord, was he surprised. Some lady grabbed a tambourine, he heard somebody shout, and he didn't know his meeting was another two doors down. The band cranked up the music and they began to rock and roll. It was quite a show. When the preacher started preaching, old Charlie started thinking about his soul. He was in the wrong place at the right time. Was the last thing on his mind. And his buddies won't believe where old Charlie's been tonight. The wrong place at the right time. When the preacher gave the invitation, Charlie was the first one on his knees. And that's when he figured out that this mistake was really meant to be. He was in the wrong place at the right time. A hallelujah meet was the last thing on his mind. And his buddies won't believe where old Charlie's been tonight.
Welcome to Music Circle tonight.
You know, we were over there listening. I was listening to the song as you were performing, and you hear the music, okay? Mm-hmm. And you want to pick up a long neck beer. And then you start listening to the lyrics and you want to set it down. You know what I'm saying?
Right. How strong is the Christian country music movement right now? Is it pretty strong?
It's getting huge. The market is growing so good. People are loving positive music, and everybody loves country music. Yeah. And when they get lyrics like they like, you know, it's growing great. It's going to be a good market.
Well, mm-hmm. now we were told that your music is having a powerful effect on the people coming to your concerts. Tell the folks about the 80-year-old man that came
up
to you.
Yeah, that's
in Topeka, Kansas. An 80-year-old man came to a concert one night, and he came up to me after the concert, and he said, do you know how to pray? And I said, yes, sir, I do. He said, I've been a wicked old man for 80 years, and I'd sure like to know this Jesus you've been singing about.
Oh, yeah?
So I introduced him to Jesus Christ, and he left that building smiling. He stuck his head back in the door, and he said, hey, boy. And I said, yes, sir. He said, I'm going to see you in heaven. Uh-huh. And it was such a great experience.
That's a wonderful story.
Yeah.
How your music makes such an impact there. I know when you came to Nashville, were you working with Ricky Skaggs or just buddies with him?
Just good friends.
Just good friends? Now,
yeah.
How much of an influence has he had on what you're doing now?
Oh, a great influence. He's been a tremendous asset to me, a great friend that is always encouraging me, and Ricky's just a great guy.
Now, how do you answer these, let's call this Christian country music. How do you answer these guys saying, well, I enjoy the music, but I only get preached at on Sunday? You know what?
Well, your music isn't exactly just preaching at
people,
is it?
Well, that's what we try to do. We don't try to preach at people. We just try to tell them that somebody loves them, somebody cares about them, and try to make a difference in lives, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, I know that a while back, several of the major mainstream country labels were very interested in you, and we were told that you turned them all down and said, no, that's not what I want to do. Now, why did you pass up on that?
Just because I feel a call in my life to sing a Christian style of music. And You know, once you got that call on your life, I just wanted to help people. And when the Christian country market opened up, it was the perfect market for me.
You're all in the right place, huh? Yeah. Man with a mission right place. Here.
It's getting bigger. Bruce, thank you. We got to take a break. Back with more Music City tonight right after this.
Look for Bruce Haynes coming soon to a city near you. And there's more to go with Pam Dillis and Randy Travis up next on Music City Tonight with Brooke and Chase.